Well, hello and welcome back, everyone. I'm Bruce Bro with the National Foundation for Danish America, and along with the Danish Pioneer, we're glad you could join us again today. Our producer, Alice, is in Beaumont, Texas. I'm in Phoenix, Arizona. Linda is in Chicago, and Benedicta is at her beautiful house just south of Silkeborg. I think she's getting ready to work in her vineyard, and they are having lovely spring Easter week weather in Denmark. Our program today is about the Danish artists P.S. Krøyer and Marie Krøyer, and the new Krøyer exhibit in Paris, France, called The Blue Hour. We're also very fortunate to have an interview with Kristen Langvold of the Skagen Art Museum. All that, along with commentary and photos from Benedicta, and we have so much enjoyed working with the Skagen Museum. They have been eager to help us, and they even added, just for our program, English subtitles to the Blue Hour video you're about to see. So we're so thankful to the Skagen Museum, and a lot happening today, and we hope you enjoy it. Next week, we will talk again with Kristen Langvold about another famous Danish artist family, the Ankers, Michael, Anna, and their daughter Helga. We've received some donations and we are so thankful for that. It has helped us greatly with the costs of these programs and with developing our new YouTube channel, where all of these recordings will be available to watch anytime you like. The YouTube channel will be up and running within the next week, and we will tell you all the details next week. So you'll be able to go back and watch all of these programs that we have done going back to Christmas. And of course, we'll have a link to the YouTube channel on our website. These recordings of Benedicta's videos have been very popular, and we want to continue to have them available. So again, thank you for your support to make this possible. So now, here's Linda Stephenson with more about today's program.
That's good, I do. Thank you, Bruce, and welcome everybody. So these are our final two shows of the season, and we're so happy to have so many people joining us from all over the United States, Denmark, Germany, UK, Norway, Canada, Australia, the US Virgin Islands, and more. We hope you have enjoyed our photo tours of Denmark through the winter, and last week's show about the Danish paperclip artist Karen Beat Vila. Today we have a new program for you featuring Skagens Museum in Denmark and the artwork of P.S. Krøyer and Marie Krøyer. Bruce informs me that we now have 500 people registered for these special Zoom webinar programs, and 1,500 people have watched the past recordings, which is really amazing. Thank you to everyone for your interest and support. My name is Linda Stephenson, and I'm Secretary of the National Foundation for Danish America and editor of the Danish Pioneer newspaper. Special thanks to Bruce, the NFDA, the Danish Pioneer, and Benedicta for presenting today's program. I wanted to give you a few quick instructions. Please note that these sessions are recorded, and the recordings will be made available shortly after each presentation at danishamerica.org. These programs are Zoom webinars, so you will only see pictures of the panelists. During the presentation, if you have any questions or comments for Benedicta, please type them in the Q&A section or the chat section throughout the program, and I will collect them and read them to Benedicta at the end, time permitting. If you have any technical difficulties, please use the raise hand button. Under view options, you can click on side-by-side speaker view to get a better speaker view of Benedicta if you wish. Finally, thank you for joining us today. Please connect with us at danishamerica.org to find our social media buttons, Facebook, Instagram, our e-news, and information about the Danish Pioneer newspaper. Now on to the show, and welcome to Benedicta for another interesting program direct from Denmark. Welcome, Benedicta.
Thank you so much. Easter week everything is Easter in Denmark now. People is home for school. People is in the summer houses everywhere. And even my son went up Friday, Saturday, Sunday to Skagen. And he told me there were so many people in Skagen and they enjoyed it so much. Now I will take you to Skagen, bring you up to, a park, the tip of Denmark, the blue hour area. And the most amazing place, we always say the sun is shining for Skagen. We can drive up, we come to Aalborg, it can be gray, cloudy, weather, raining, we pass Limfjord, we come over to the north side of Aalborg, and then getting more blue sky, and we come up to Skagen, and the sun is nearly always shining. So here we are still på Sønderstrand, på Skagen, and we are going into this amazing couple, Marie and Peter Severin Krøyer. Krøyer was born in Norway, in Stavanger. His mom was mental sick. He is born in Norway, February the 23rd, in 1851. And his mom decided to send him to Copenhagen to a sister to her, also in Moster. So he grew up with a moster in Copenhagen, and they adopted Krøyer, and they gave him their last name, Krøyer. So he had not his really parents around him, but a wonderful, beloved moster. And there he grew up in Copenhagen, and he was really, he had the artist, the painter in the blood. He was very, very young when he started. And then we have the wonderful Marie, we see Marie Krøyer, and they met, and I will come to that later on. But this picture, that is from Rom, you see that? That was when they were newly wed, and they were so in love and had a wonderful time. They were so much in love. So as two artists, Marie was from Copenhagen, she was from Frederiksberg. Her name was Teipke, her last name, Marie Teipke, and her parents lived in Germany when she met Krøyer. So she studied painting in Copenhagen. He has studied, he was in Paris, she came to Paris, they met in Paris. Now it was before the World Exhibition in 1889, and they met there. And they were so in love, so they decided to paint a double picture. So you see here the painting. She painted him and he painted her. That is very, very, that is not normal for artists, but they did. They were so respectful to each other. And that is what we see, what come out of their love. They loved after 1889 in Paris, the same year the Eiffel Tower was built as a symbol for the World Exhibition in Paris. And Krøyer was in charge of all the art that came from Denmark. And he was in charge to hang it up at the exhibition in Paris in 1889. And actually my great-grandfather was the Danish, the mayor of Copenhagen, and he was in charge, the head of the whole exhibition, and brought a lot of art, decided together with Krøyer what to bring to Paris. But there in Paris, also Angers were there. So that meant so much to them. They met each other. They ended up to be very good friends. And here we see why Krøyer ended up to be so famous with the blue light. Here we have at the museum in Skagen, Marie, and there we have Anna Anker, and she will be on the screen next week for full screen. And here we have the Alba Maxima Rose, the Krøyer Rose. And there see we Krøyer with his palette painting. We can nearly maybe see it, but he was really in trouble, mental. Here he had painted his self-portrait himself, and I like it, I think it's gorgeous. And that is from Sønderstrand, the South Beach, the Skagen. And there he's standing by Krøyer House. And when you come to Denmark, you have to go to Skagen. You have to take some days and you have to say, I will stay in some days. have a room and then really explore it, for there's so much to see. And that is Krøyer's house, and you will love to go in there and see that too. Here he is on the steps, see his shoes, see his dress, and always smoking for something. And here there you see the whole house, and there you see he's on the steps, and Maria sitting there and the dog. Og så har vi vidunderlige, beautiful Marie. She always have something when you see her, the way she look at us. Maybe not so happy as we want her to be. And I love that photo. I think it's gorgeous, gorgeous. This beautiful girl and young lady. And Krøyer had mentioned that she was the most beautiful lady at all in Copenhagen. He found the most beautiful at them all, Marie. And there we see Marie sit by the rose bush, the Alba Maxima, and Krøyer painted it. And I told you in earlier shows that it is really one of the amazing arts we see all over the world from Krøyer's hand, and also that the rose changed name to, is still called Krøyer Rosen. Here I found wonderful pictures from the time when there really was a family. Here we see Vibeke, Vipse, their daughter. We see here we have Marie Krøyer, and there we have Anna Anker. There we have Anker, there we have Krøyer. And I think that is Mrs. Brøndum. I'm not sure who it is, but they sit there in the garden and have a nice time. And there we have Marie and Vibe, Vipse was her name. Krøyer always called her daughter Vipse. And she was born 6 years after the marriage. So they are Marie Krøyer and her daughter. And they also had a beautiful villa på Østerbro in Copenhagen. They had the Skagens house, lived there most of the time, but they could go to Copenhagen in the wintertime på Bergensgade på Østerbro. And then we see this gorgeous painting. 2 years after the marriage, Krøyer paint this gorgeous painting of Maria. I think it's just so pretty, so pretty. And I am so sure she loved Krøyer so much. And she was just, oh, she wanted to get all the love from him. But he had a problem to give love to her. So that was really their big troubles. And here we see the gorgeous Anna and Maria. Marie and I think they were so close, so close. They could really talk about the problems at home, the problem with Krøyer, and share their daily days life. Those two amazing artists, two ladies, that show how they could live, married, have home, and do their work. They were full-time painters at that time. Think about it, in 1890, it's amazing. They were fundraiser from us ladies already at that time. And that is Krøyer. Maria is out living wildflowers, and I love it so much, it's so pretty. And here Krøyer have painted Overplantør Dallerup med Jagthunden in 1898. And that is an overplanteur was the man that planted all marhalm in the dunes and trees, so the sand was not blowing away the whole Skagen. An overplanteur, he planted and was a chef for them that worked. And there we had Drachmann. Drachmann was an amazing painter too. We could make a whole say about him too. Drachmann art, and he wrote and he did psalms and songs, and he was an amazing person for Skagen too. And they were very good friends. Drachmann was always, he has so many paintings from Krøyer's hand. And here we have vodtrækkerne. They trækker vod. They take the net, fishing net, and then they go along the coast and take all the fish into the beach. And here you see, and every person is persons with names in Skagen, and everyone know who they were. And here we have Krøyer's, one of his first sanghans, paintings. That is from 1903. The last one is from 1906. But here you see, he is starting, that is a little bit more abstract, but he still have the lighthouse out over here. He still have the moon, but it is not shining in the water. It will come later on in the next picture, but still where he take all the people he know and he put them into the scene of what he is doing. And here we have his masterpiece. I call it Magnus Opus, so the best, his probably one of the best paintings he did at all. See how the moon is shining down in the Baltic Sea. See every person, and it is all his friends, Drachmann and wife, Lille Vipse, Vibeke there, the kids, and then all Krøyer's neighbors and all them from Skagen that were important to him. And then the bonfire, and then his love Marie, but she is so miserable in that marriage, so she had fallen in love to Alf Wien. And that is the tragedy for them, and we will come in on that later on. Yeah. And there we see them, Marie Krøyer and Wien, and standing there, that must have been tough for Krøyer to see them standing there in the hole. That is for Drachmann, they're standing there. Hugo Alf Wien was also, he was a composer and musician for Sweden. And later on the marriage, yeah. Here is a Harald Skagen still, that tower was at that time at Skagen, the Grå Tårn, Fyrtårn as a lighthouse, and with the flag. And Vibbefyrt, that is so important for there is in so many paintings too, and we'll see more. And the blue sky I'm talking about at Skagen. And here we see how Krøyer is now turning more and more. He was very, 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 very dark in the beginning, and then he turned more and more and more and more blue, and he learned it in Paris. And that's what everything about Paris come in, because he learned so much in Paris over the year. 50 years. 50 years he traveled to Paris every single year to learn more of how to paint in another way compared to what Danes was doing. But he was from Nordstrand, the north tip of Skagen. And that's the photo from last summer I took up in the evening before sunset. And the beautiful building still there. You can come stay there, enjoy it. Sunset over Skagen and Gamle Skagen, beautiful. And here we have Marie, painted of Krøyer. And now I will stop my pictures and you will see much more later on. But now we will go in to see the, have the conversation with Kristen Langvold from Skagen Kunstmuseum. Oh, that would be so nice. We had a very nice conversation with Grace, and you can enjoy it. He is a fantastic employee to Skagen Museum. So just set the conversation on and we will hear what he has to say to what we were asking him about. But you see the painting here is Marie standing in a beautiful room, and Krøyer again have taken this light, the sart, green, sart, white. See the blouse, see the belt. And where she, oh my God, the paintings we see now today, that is exactly what the young girls were wearing of dress. That is the dress we can be wearing today. Isn't that amazing?
We are talking to Kristen Langvold of the Skagen Art Museum in Denmark. Kristen, thank you so much for talking to us.
You're so welcome.
And it's great to have you there in Skagen's museum. And we see behind you the famous Krøyer painting of Sankthans Aften. So great that you could do this and,
yes.
And talk I see to us from the museum.
I see behind you a very nice photo of the very tip north point of Denmark.
Yeah. I wish I was there. I wish it wasn't just a photo. So first of all, Kristen, Many of us watching today are Americans with Danish heritage. Maybe their grandparents came over from Denmark. We may have only been to Denmark once or twice, or maybe we've never been to Denmark. So I would like you to tell us, what would you like Americans to know about the Skagen Art Museum?
The Skagen Art Museum is placed on the very top of Denmark, like in the photo behind you. And we are in fact in the same distance from Oslo as from Copenhagen, and we have only about 60 kilometers to the Swedish coast. So we are a center point in Scandinavia. You will meet as many Danes, as Norwegians, as Swedes. The Skagen Art Museum is the fifth greatest museum in Denmark when it comes to visitors. We have 170,000 visitors per year. And that is when taken in perspective that we are only a small town of about 8,000 people living here all year. So we have an enormous amount of visitors. And because of that, we are almost able to finance our own work. We have a percentage of 85 to undertake and only need 15% from local authorities and the state to run this very large museum that has more than 9,000 paintings from the Skagen painters, and further than the museum contains two small houses which were inhabited by the Anker family and the Drachmann family.
Well, it's a beautiful museum complex. I've been there a couple of times, and I would certainly recommend everybody visit whenever they come to Denmark. We want to talk about the Krøyers, and I would like to ask you, Kristen, why are P.S. Krøyer and Marie Krøyer such important artists in Denmark?
It's because the period that they represent is very underlines very much the situation and the country Denmark is today. In the 1800s, we had very many troubles in Denmark. In 1814, we lost Norway. In 1864, we lost Schleswig and Holstein. And we became, from being a middle-sized, great European nation, we became a very small nation. And that meant that Denmark turned its eyes inside on itself and became a small nationalistic state. Then in about 1875, there was a liberal movement coming from the peasants and from school teachers and so on that wanted to liberalize the society. And in this period, these artists came to be the expression of these movements of liberalization socially, that you should be able to move in society, not be decided from what your family was born like, but have a social mobility. And also they were liberalized in thoughts and minds. Among other things, they were front runners in the process of getting voting rights and liberties for women. So they became a picture on the new and modern and liberalized Danish society.
It was the golden age of Danish art, wasn't it?
No, it was in fact the golden age of Danish art that was before them, because this was the natural romantic period. But these painters said that we should be realists, we should paint things as they are, but they also put themselves in place to demonstrate something that was nice and beautiful and so on. So it is the golden age of the painters in Skagen, but not, if you say the golden age in Denmark, they would think of a period before this that was nationalistic and romantic.
Benedikt is here with us as well. I would like to turn it over to Benedikt to ask you some questions.
Yeah. Christen, we will start with, why is there an exhibition about Krøyers in Paris? Why did that, how did that start? Will you tell a little bit about that?
Yeah, you can look at it from the perspective of today, from the perspective of today, it was because we have made a collaboration with Museum Marmonet Motin in Paris with all the Monet paintings, and we have a 3-year long alliance with them to show our things by them and their things by us. But that's today. The reason why these two museums are working together is because the Danish painters in Skagen were very inspired of what happened in Paris in the late 1870s and beginning of 1880s. In fact, Krøyer stayed there for 3 years and looked at all these new French painters like Monet, Gauguin and people like that, and therefore they will see what the Danes brought home from Paris and made here, and we will show them and we will have their paintings up here to show a Danish audience what inspired the Skagen painters.
Yeah, and then we come to, what is the Blue Hour? Please tell us about that.
Yeah, it is, the Blue Hour is a natural phenomena that you have in the far north regions, and especially with a lot of sand and a lot of ocean. When the sun sets in the summertime, it only just comes beneath the horizon. You can see in the north direction north that the sun is just under the horizon all the time, and that means that you have blue colors in the sky also in the nighttime. And when the sun and the ocean reflects all these light phenomena, you have a vision of a very, very blue horizon, and an hour or two between 10 and midnight in the summertime, where the horizon turns completely blue and everything around you is blue.
It's so
and that
gorgeous.
Gives this very comforting peacefulness in the summertime with these blue colors. And that was what Krøyer loved so much, to calm down his troubled mind.
Yes, yes. How far ahead are exhibitions planned? Months or year for you? Those exhibitions?
In fact, it can almost sound Russian, but we have a 5-year plan.
Wow.
We plan for 5 years what we will do. Of course, the exhibition that we have planned 5 years from now is only in the ideas. Mm-hmm. But the exhibition that we will do, not the, the following, in 1 year, we are starting to ask different other museums for lending us paintings, decide how the exhibition shall be made and so on. So we work hardly on the exhibition 1 year from now.
Okay. Thank you.
And but have a plan for 5 years.
Yes. Yeah. Krøyer, what type of education do you have?
Well, I'm more or less autodidact in everything, but my basic education is as a lawyer. I'm educated lawyer, but have worked most of my years inside hotel and restaurants with the service and for the I've been working at Brøndums Hotel, which is very close to Skagens Museum, and for the last 5 years I have been working with art and with explaining and showing art for
thank you visitors. Great, you're doing great. Yeah. Are the Krøyer still popular in Denmark? If yes, why?
I can answer yes. I was thinking about this and said, well, is Clark Gable still popular in USA? And of course he is, because he was a phenomena in his time and was very well known. And in the same way, you can say Krøyer is very popular, but when you come to certain generations, maybe more than in other generations.
Mm-hmm. Are they popular with the young Danes?
I would say yes, but maybe in another way than among elders. I can mostly refer to it as how popular are your very well-known Hollywood actors from generations mm-hmm. before. They are not forgotten, they are not disliked, but maybe it's most mm-hmm. in the minds of people that have come to a little age.
Is it the light from the Master Krøyer? That's my explanation that I think he is the master in the lover of light, people love. That must be the
it's of course his fantastic paintings in a combination with a personal history that is rather remarkable too. And then it is that he really was the great master of his time. 1 year ago, we had an exhibition with five of his masterpieces, five big paintings containing 193 different persons in these paintings. More or less like you see this only as a small version with his own friends. But he painted for Carl Jacobsen, the owner of Carlsberg Breweries. He painted for all the big scientists in Denmark, painted a picture of 5 meter long and 3 meters high with 51 Danish scientists having a meeting. And people were very, very impressed with his ability to describe people, not only so you were able to see who they were, but he always found out something certain person would do, pill his ear, pick his nose, something like that. So people were saying, oh, that can only be him, not because I can see it is him, but he's acting exactly like he's doing in real life. So therefore, people still is very fond of Krøyer. Mm-hmm. And of course, all of his love story with the beautiful 16-year younger wife, Marie Krøyer.
Oh, yeah. Great. Can you tell us about the research collaboration between Museum Monet in Paris and Skagen, but you actually nearly did it.
Yeah,
but,
it's very nice for us because this is one of the most recognized museums in the world, and we have painters here that connects very well with the works of Monet. So in that way, it enlightens us and it gives us possibilities to search and research our own painters with knowledge about what they saw and what they did when they were out traveling Europe to get inspiration and bring it back here. So it's very, very giving to us and to the other. So it's really a high point for us.
Thank you, Kristen, for all the nice explanation about the Krøyer. Thank you so much.
You're so welcome, and you're always welcome in Skagens Museum in Skagen on the top of Jutland in Denmark. I would like to see you all here. Thank you very much for stopping by.
Yeah. We could listen to him. I could listen to him much more. It was so nice. Yeah.
We'll hear from him again next week talking about the Onkers.
Exactly.
So Alice and Alex, whenever you're ready with the Blue Hour, thank you.
Den nordligste spids i Danmark, der hvor havene mødes, naturen er barsk og lyset særligt. Her opstod i slutningen af 1800-tallet en af Danmarks gennem tiderne mest indflydelsesrige kunstnerkolonier. Det lille fiskerleje Skagen var tilholdsstedet, og kunstnerne fandt motiver til deres friluftsmalerier i naturen og blandt de lokale, men også i fællesskabet af kunstnere. Kunstnere som P.S. Krøyer, Michael og Anna Anker kom med strømninger fra hele Europa til dette afsides sted.
Så man har kommet her for at male og for at udvikle sin kunst og dyrke friluftsmaleriet. Men når man så havde fri, så blev der slappet af og snakket, diskuteret kunsten og holdt fester.
P.S. Krøyer var allerede en etableret kunstner, da han første gang slog sig ned i Skagen i sommeren 1882.
Han er kendt, og han kommer med alle sine erfaringer fra Frankrig i bagagen og har vist det frem på de danske udstillinger, så de andre kunstnere ved, hvem han er.
P.S. Krøyer malede mange af sine vigtigste malerier i Skagen, i det fri med de motiver, der omgav ham. Nu skal et af hans mest kendte værker, Sommeraften på Skagen, Sønderstrand, sammen med en række andre Krøyer-værker til Paris i den største internationale soloudstilling i nyere tid.
Værket blev udstillet i Paris, og derfor er det rart at se, at det vender tilbage.
P.S. Krøyer blev født under trange kår i Norge i 1851. Faderen er ukendt, og moren så hårdt ramt af psykisk sygdom, at hun ikke kan tage vare på sit barn. Krøyer får derfor i stedet for sin opvækst i København hos morens søster. Hans talent for at tegne er exceptionelt, og det får ham ind på kunstskolen i en tidlig alder. Og allerede som 19-årig er Krøyer færdiguddannet fra Kunstakademiet i København.
Krøyer er skolet af nationalromantikken på Kunstakademiet i Danmark.
Men han er også en del af det gryende moderne gennembrud, og ønsker at komme ud i verden for at hente inspiration og fornyelse med hjem til den danske kunstscene. I 1877 ankommer Krøyer til Paris. En by, som på mange måder bliver central for den unge Krøyer. Ikke blot blomstrer kærligheden her, men den kunstneriske inspiration, han henter med hjem, og det livslange forhold til Paris' kunstscene, får stor betydning for Krøyers virke.
Il arrive à Paris au mois de juin, c'est-à-dire au moment de la plus grande activité artistique parisienne, puisque c'est le moment où se tient le salon. C'est le moment où l'École des Beaux-Arts expose les travaux des élèves pensionnés de Rome. C'est un moment très, très important. Je pense que la peinture de Monet en 1877, ça le dérangerait, il ne comprendrait pas tout à fait. Il faut pour ça un cheminement qui va passer donc, par ses séjours à Cernay-la-Ville ou à Concarneau, quelque chose qui va l'ouvrir sur une autre manière d'aborder la peinture.
Da Krøyer kommer til Paris, der er det en helt anden type kunst, han ser, end hvad han har været vant til her i Danmark. Han kan ikke forstå, hvorfor værkerne ikke er færdige.
Krøyer indskriver sig på Léon Bonnards kunstskole og bliver optaget af den nye naturalisme.
Jeg pense que les moments importants qui vont orienter la carrière de Krøyer, c'est un peu après son premier voyage. C'est après 1878, après 1879, puisqu'il ne vient pas tous les ans, hein, c'est après l'irruption du naturalisme.
Det er både i forhold til motivvalg, og så er det også i forhold til måden at male på. Det er ikke længere de historiske scener, men det er almindelige mennesker. Det er arbejderne, det er bønderne, det er fiskerne. På et tidspunkt kalder han sig selv for fiskermaler. Så han danner sig en identitet ud fra sit motivvalg.
Godt 10 år senere, da Krøyer er tilbage i Paris i 1888, møder han den unge danske kunstner Marie Tripke. Marie har været Krøyers elev i København, men det var i Paris, at mødet mellem de to bliver til kærlighed. I 1889 skifter de sig og tager på bryllupsrejse et helt år til Italien for at male sammen, før de vender tilbage til Danmark.
Krøyer og Marie Krøyer, de var et meget celebert par. Det var sådan et powerpar, som man gerne ville skrive om i aviserne. Hun var aldeles smuk, og han var jo efterhånden rig og berømt. Så det var et spændende par at beskæftige sig med.
De maler dette dobbeltportræt sammen i 1890. Marie maler PS, og PS maler Marie.
Det er svært at sige ret meget om, hvordan de har set hinanden, fordi vi kan ikke se dem over skulderen. Vi ved ikke, hvad de har tænkt og hvad de har drømt om. Men noget af det, man kan se i det billede, det er, at de anerkender hinanden som kunstnere. Ellers ville de ikke have malet på det samme lærred. Man ser relativt tydeligt, at de har hver sin stil og har fået hver deres uddannelse inden for maleriet. Man ser, at Krøyer han er meget detaljeret og meget jævn og udfører et virkelig smukt portræt af sin hustru i det her billede. Man ser på den anden side, at Marie Krøyer er en yngre kunstner, der har fået en anden uddannelse end Krøyer, og derfor fører penslen lidt anderledes.
Marie er nu en del af Krøyers motivverden, sammen med fiskerne, de lokale børn og kunstnerfællesskabet. Blandt de mange kunstnere i Skagen er fastboerne Anna og Michael Anker. Anna og Marie kender hinanden fra Alfred Philip Rolls kunstskole i Paris. En sommeraften i en skumringstime, hvor de to kunstnere og venner, Marie og Anna, går langs vandkanten, fanger Krøyer dem i et fotografi, som bliver brugt til skitse til det, der bliver et af hans mest berømte malerier.
Den ene, Anna Anker, en kendt og anerkendt kunstner i Danmark, og den anden, en Marie Krøyer, en kunstner, der kun udstillede ganske få gange og havde svært ved at opretholde en kunstnerisk produktion. Det vi ser i maleriet sommeraften på Skagen Sønderstrand, det er en tusmørkestemning, som han i forvejen har beskæftiget sig med tidligere, men her bevæger han sig et skridt længere hen imod et stemningsmaleri, der ikke har 100% rod i virkeligheden.
Med sommeraften på Skagens Sønderstrand bevæger Krøyer sig væk fra naturalismen.
Han begynder at manipulere en lille smule med virkeligheden. Han ændrer på kontrasterne, farverne. Han fjerner det tang, som vi kan se på fotografiet. Det er ikke længere til stede på stranden i maleriet. Han ændrer på farverne, sådan så båndet omkring Marie Krøyers liv, det er gult eller orange i farverne, hvor på fotografiet, der kan man se, det er sort. Så farverne, de skal passe med hans virkelighed og ikke med den virkelighed, han har set.
On est en 94, donc on est à un moment où en France il y a un nouveau mouvement artistique qui se développe, qui est le symbolisme. Et le symbolisme, donc, c'est plus du tout le monde de la réalité, c'est le monde du rêve, c'est le monde de l'esprit. Et vous avez ces deux femmes qui déambulent sur ce bord de mer, la mer et la terre, deux femmes qui déambulent, c'est un côté éminemment symboliste et mélancolique. Et je pense que les gens y ont vu une scène de genre, mais y ont vu aussi quelque chose qui allait plus loin, qui était une réflexion sur l'existence, la nature humaine, ou la nature tout simplement.
Krøyer har malet den blå time, som vi kalder det, altså en tusmørke stemning i Skagen. På den ene side et utroligt simpelt værk, men på den anden side så er det virkelig håndværksmæssigt godt konstrueret. Der er rigtig mange ting i det her værk, som er interessant at gå dybere ind i, og det er bare noget, der kan tale til os umiddelbart i dag. Det her er et værk, der er meget skrøbeligt, og det rejser sjældent. Så normalt så låner vi det ikke ud til udstillinger. Det her det er noget, vi har prioriteret, fordi vi synes, det er vigtigt at vise Krøyers værk, der hvor det også hører til.
Jeg ser efter, om der er nogle skader på maleriet. Altså, det er jo et maleri, som er over 100 år gammel. Og det vil sige, at det har været i alle mulige slags klima. Farvelaget har stået og bevæget sig på grund af lærret. Det står og bevæger sig alt efter, om det er et tørt klima eller om det er et fugtigt klima. Så det vil sige, at det skal ud af det klima, der er her på Skagen og så ned til Frankrig.
Der var en lang periode efter 2. verdenskrig, hvor det var en anden type kunst, der var i fokus og i centrum. Og der var Krøyers kunst noget, man så på som næsten som kitsch. I dag der er holdningen helt anderledes. Man er begyndt at interessere sig meget mere for den her periode. Og dermed er Krøyer også blevet relevant for os i dag.
À Paris. Personne ne connaît Krøyer, mais tout le monde connaît Krøyer. Alors pourquoi? Parce que à Paris, on voit plein d'expositions, on voit plein d'artistes et on ne retient pas forcément les noms. Vous sortez ce tableau et tout le monde dit « Ah bah oui !» Parce qu'en fait, il est déjà venu à Paris. Il a été utilisé pour beaucoup de couvertures de livres, il a été reproduit dans beaucoup d'ouvrages sur la peinture. Et donc, Krøyer n'est pas un inconnu, mais il n'avait pas eu de rétrospective à Paris. Et donc là, c'est un concours de circonstances qui permet de montrer un peu plus et de faire que, à la fin de l'exposition, je pense, les Parisiens se souviendront de qui est Krøyer.
Krøyers sidste store værk, Sankt Hans Plus ved Skagen Strand, blev skabt hen over 14 år, og han døde blot få år efter i 1909.
Så det, han viser os her, det er kunstnerkolonien, sådan som han ser den i 1906. Den indkapsler ligesom alt det, der er ham nært og kært i den her periode. Det er lyset med fyrtårnet her, ilden og månen. Det er hans venner, familie, kunstnerkollegaer og lokalsamfundet her i Skagen.
Til venstre ser vi Marie og P.S. Krøyers datter Vibeke, og bag os i billedet Marie Krøyer med den mand, den svenske komponist Hugo Alvén, som hun senere skulle gifte sig med. Idyllen vi ser i sommeraften på Skagen Sønderstrand er brudt. Marie og P.S. Krøyer bliver skilt. Marie flytter til Sverige, og Krøyer bukker under for sygdom og sindslidelser kort tid efter.
Krøyer er teknisk dygtig, og han har et blik for naturen og for virkeligheden og for den menneskelige følelse og for lyset. Han mestrer det hele til perfektion.
P.S. Krøyer er udstillet på museer verden over. Men det er første gang, at Krøyer får en soludstilling i Paris i nyere tid. Byen, som Krøyer besøgte hvert år det meste af sit liv. Hvis kunstscene han følte sig så forbundet med, og hvor han mødte kærligheden. Nu vender Krøyer tilbage med det skandinaviske blå lys.
I have to say, I have promised for the museum in Skagens to say that the producer of this movie, The Blue Hours, was made of immersive stories in cooperation with Skagen Art Museum and Musée Marmottan Monet and the Danish Embassy in Paris. They have all been part of that movie. Yeah. And now we will continue, and you see this gorgeous painting, and that is Marie, and that is after the wedding. Now they're in Italy. Now Krøyer finds her lover, her love, beautiful Marie in this chair, and that is, I like that picture, it's so gorgeous. And here we see Marie. See Marie, how she, and if you like, do this like you could, like the telescope, you will see how excellent her painting is. See how she was inspired of something in Italy. Her rose, again, if you go down and look it, you will see, oh my, she really can. That was from April, the 21st of April, 98. Marie KMK, you can see. And the Avevon, beautiful art from Skagen, and Tørsnoren, the wash closet, what we always do, we drive our stuff outside in Denmark. That is Marie's art. And this one, again, if you really want to look into it like I do, make a little pipeline, then you will see, wow, her light is incredible. Marie was gorgeous. Here is Krøyer that painted Marie on the wedding honeymoon. And then Krøyer's amazing international paintings. He loved France, he loved Italy, and see how he really could take that to him too, not just Skagen and the fishermen and all that. And here, I just love it. His painting, the landscape, the volcano Etna, and you see the Etna volcano is up there, that is in Sicily. And here, see what his inspiration came from that spot. He is here, and you have still the volcano Etna over here. And he is in this gorgeous, from the Roman time, watching out from the column over there. And then he found the inspiration. And the same motif outside the old Roman building. Here again, we have the volcano and then the cactus, the blooming cactus in 1890 on there. Wedding, the honeymoon. And again, how it looks like in real time. Here he had so French workers coming, and it was the master of take all these faces in and show it to us like a photo. And that is Tove Benson, and Krøyer did her already in 1883 wave before he met Marie and the Sart color. But that is a painting to a very good family, friends of Krøyer, their daughter. And dear Marie in the garden in Skagen, beautiful. Now he had the light. And that is Krøyer's little daughter, his daughter, Vepse, Vibeke. And she is like a little bride with brudeslør and bouquet and everything. And here she's standing there on the beach and see all the kids is out swimming, but she had to stay there with hat and shoes and everything. And there she is. Isn't she cute? Vibeke Krøyer. And she had a tough, tough life too. Now mom had left father Krøyer, and Vibeke has to be back in Skagen. They will keep her in Skagen, and mom can go to Sweden to Alvin if she like. And mom goes to Alvin in Sweden and lives at the Alvin farmhouse, Alvin Gården. And that is Marie Krøyer. And then Alvin and Maria, they got a daughter, Margitta. Margitta Alvin, and that is Margitta that is sitting here at Alvin Gården with her mom. And that is the beautiful Margitta. And Margitta lived with her mom and Father Alvin. But Marie Krøyer never waited 6 years to marry Alvin because she had that terrible feeling that she should give up Vibeke, Vibeke, and let her stay in Skagen when he left Krøyer, when she left Krøyer. So she really don't want to lose daughter number two. So that's the reason she never waited 6 years before she married Alvin to be sure he could not take a daughter from her. Tough life. And there you see Vibeke, Krøyer's daughter, and you can see she is mentally sick too. She had hereditated the same illness as her father. So that is very, very tough. First, late on in life, she came to Sweden when Krøyer died, and she came up to her mom. She moved into Alvin Gården, and she lived there until she died. She died in Sweden, born på Skagen. And here is amazing. I love that painting. That is very close, 3 months before Krøyer died. He he really don't want Anker to be come and learn to take all his motifs and all that. He just want to be the one Krøyer. But anyway, after long, long, long friendship between Anker and Krøyer, here you see, he say, this painting, he said, till Mikael Anker. And then I think it says 8th of July, 1909. Fra Søren, Krøyer called him, he was always called Søren, not Peter Severin, but Søren. And so that is the last painting Krøyer did, and he made it out to Anker to say, thank you for your friendship. And that was 3 months before he died. He cannot even use this eye, it is not working, and this is very bad too. And you can see he is an ill man. And that is his graveyard, and you can see that he died October 11th, 2011, then 2 November 1909, and there for Skagen Kirkegård. And that is the old stone from the beginning, and then 100 years later, and that's now they have cleaned up and make it so nice as you saw. But you can see here, that's the 100th day for his, when he died, and some had put a palette and pencil into his grave, that's very nice, in 2009. And here we see Marie Krøyer married Alvin and got the name Maria, and I don't know why, Maria Alvin, and died in 40. And Margitta, the daughter Alvin, and then you see Vibeke, Vibeke Krøyer from Skagen, then moved up to Sweden and died. And they, three girls, mom and two daughters, is still here in Sweden. The whole story about Maria and P.S. Krøyer is made in a Bille August, wonderful, wonderful movie. And I think you should try, if you haven't tried to see it, I have told you that before. And that is from the movie, Sitting at the Krøyer House. And again from the movie, and here we see what but he was painted with a dog, and that is the one we actually know, but it was the daughter that should play the dog at that time when he was painting. And here we see Bill August standing with Maria and the little baby, and from the whole scene when Marie Krøyer is ready to leave Krøyer and go to Sweden. And that is a wonderful book, Balladen om Marie, and that is the basis for the movie. Tony Arnold, the biography of Marie Krøyer. And here, that is how it looks today if you come to Skagen and see Krøyer and Anker standing beside strong, amazing artists. Both of them mean so much to Denmark and to Skagen and to every one of us. And that is the garden where they went, and that's where we have the cafe when we go to Skagen, and then the beautiful Skagen Museum. How it looks when you come there, and I want you to come there and see it. It is gorgeous. And that is, Krøyer was a party boy, and there was champagne and bottles on the table all the time. And here we see, like we heard about, and there we have Anna, and there's little Helga, and then we have Marie, and then we have them all here. And they were hip, hip, hurrah, and they had so many parties. So I will say hip, hip, hurrah for the fantastic Krøyer family and Marie Krøyer here at the base. Thank you for this tour to Skagen Museum and the Krøyer. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Benedikta. Another wonderful program. We have a few questions for you. So, it was already answered, but the age difference between P.S. and Marie.
Yeah, Krøyer was born in 1851 and Marie in 1867. So there was a little bit 15 years between them. Yeah.
So did P.S. have any sisters or brothers from his adopted parents in Copenhagen?
Yeah, no. He has actually a brother more up from Norway, from Stavanger, that also was sent down to the muster in Copenhagen, yes.
And when exactly is the Blue Hour? The Blue Hour, the dusk?
That is about, if it is a day like today where we have had blue sky, you have to have the blue sky, and what I'm told you in the beginning, you nearly have that all the time up at Skagen. But anyway, it has to be this wonderful, wonderful blue sunny day, and then before it gets dark, for you have the sunset, and then, but it is there, you have this, it is in the evening, it's just, I can't say 8 or 9 o'clock, because it's also if you are in June or July or August, September, it changes, but it is there in the evening. You can see the moon is already out there with the picture we have here. So you can see the moon is there, and it's already, so you can see, so it's late in the evening before, just before it gets dark. So that could easily be late. It's easy be 11 to midnight, 10 or 11.
And then the final question, when Krøyer painted the large groups of people, did he paint from a photo or did he have each individual pose?
I think it was from the photo. When we take the big from this enormous picture where you have there somewhere you have 100 people in the place, and I think they have had the photo to have remember everyone how they were standing or sitting. And
then we just had two more questions come in. Did Van Gogh ever meet Krøyer?
What?
Van Gogh? Did he ever meet Krøyer?
I haven't checked with the dates and the life, but if Van Gogh was at that time there, I'm pretty sure they were hermits. But Krøyer were there for so many, he must have, but he was there so many years, and he was a part of the artist in Paris too. So I think so.
Then we have one final question. Is the Blue Hour only a phenomenon in the summertime, not the rest of the year?
Yeah, we have so many different kind of, as sometimes, for example, here, the last months, when we were up at the summer house, I have told Paul, look, it is nearly the Blue Hour now. It is, so it can actually come, it's come again about the sunshine and how the the light is, it's not, you cannot say it is there. That's the same. You cannot go to Norway and see the midsummer sun. You can go all the way up and there is no midsummer sun. You never know. It's always, weather is weather, and not so easy to handle.
So that's it for the questions for this week, but we certainly want to thank Krøysten for his participation, Benedikt and Bruce for the interview, Alex and Alice for your help today. So we're looking forward to next week again. And we want to thank all of our viewers for joining us. Please note that the webinar link that you have received will be the same link that we're going to use next week. Our final presentation of the season will be Tuesday, April 6th at 11 a.m. Chicago time, where we will again visit with the Skagens Museum in Denmark. And this time we're going to learn about the beautiful and outstanding artwork of the famous Danish painters Michael and Anna Anker on April 6th. Please join us, share the news with your family and friends, and thank you on behalf of the NFDA, the Danish Pioneer, Bruce, Benedikt, and myself. Stay safe and well, everyone, and we look forward to seeing you next week. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone.